Good day, everyone. My name is Dr. David Amron. I'm the host of Lippy Logic at the Lippy Lounge. Welcome to another segment. Today's topic is going to be about markings, incision points, and positioning. A very, very important topic also. So many people talk about artistry and skills and tools in terms of doing liposuction, but I've realized that what I have done or what I do, and I've talked about this in other segments, I have designed and engineered a very systematic process of going about doing liposuction. It involves cosmetic units, staying in a safe plane, the importance of all that. When you're doing liposuction, you've got to remember you're staying in a plane between the skin and the muscle, that safe plane of the subcutaneous tissue. It's important to stay only in that safe plane. There's no reason to get out of that plane. And you're using instruments, which are typically metal instruments called cannulas, that don't bend. And you're using these instruments in curved areas of the body. Many times these areas curve very quickly, around the calf and ankle, for example. And the importance of staying in that safe plane with these instruments and how you're doing it. And I've talked about this, avoiding general anesthesia to get the best result, to do it safely. And all these things play into it. You have to have your markings very precise. You have to have your incision points very precise. And these incision points are small nicks in the skin. They're between 2 and 3 millimeter, very strategically placed little slits in the skin that heal beautifully. And then finally, you have to have your patient positioning perfectly right to get the best result with things. I want you now to turn on your back, and I want you to rotate up and over all the way onto your left side now, okay? Again, another reason why I don't prefer general anesthesia, because it's a technical disadvantage. So let's take a look at some examples here. This first example shows different areas of the body. The first one being the calves and ankles and the markings of the calves and ankles to be able to do it circumferentially. And I break up the markings or the areas into triads. There's an anterior triad, a medial posterior triad, and a lateral posterior triad. There are markings around the tibia bone to define that shin bone beautifully. And that's why when you see a lot of my results after, you see how perfectly that shin bone is defined in the surgery itself. And you can see also the access points of where I do this. They're always placed, the incision points, at the periphery of the cosmetic unit, and I'm sculpting in two different directions respecting the natural skin tension lines. The next area is the thigh area, how the markings are done. In the thigh area, I do in quadrants. There is an anterior quadrant, a medial quadrant, a lateral quadrant, and a posterior quadrant, defining the cosmetic unit all done at one time. And again, where the incision points are placed very precisely is extremely important. The next area is the torso area when that is done in patients, either with the pelvic girdle being done, the hip upper buttock area, but commonly the whole abdomen is done and the whole upper back area is done, again, as one circumferential unit, and the importance of the exactly placed incision points. The next area is the upper arm area in terms of how that is done circumferentially with the markings and the placement of incision points, again, at the periphery of the cosmetic unit. And finally, the forearm area, when that needs to be done in certain patients. Probably about 25% of patients I do, the forearms need to be done, and this is the way in which I mark and do the forearm area. We can see the importance of patient positioning. In this photograph, you see the way in which the calf and ankle unit is positioned precisely. The patient is also locking their muscle. The importance of not having just loose, flabby muscle, especially when the thigh area is done, the patient tightens up their muscle, so I'm able to very precisely contour and sculpt over that muscle and around the shape of that muscle, creating that perfect three-dimensional shape to areas like the calves and ankles and the thigh area. Again, remember, these are circumferential areas. They go around, they curve quickly, and you're using straight instruments to do these. And that's the whole beauty of the design that I've engineered into this process. My name is Dr. David Amron. I hope you enjoyed this segment of Lippy Logic at the Lippy Lounge. Thank you for tuning in, and please keep tuning in to more of these. Thank you so much.